If you're like most people, you don't normally have the time to read through every single item in a readme list after a new piece of software comes out. But this is one of those things that I felt I needed to make a video and highlight just because it's something that I've been waiting for a really long time, which is support for CUDA-based r3d with the latest Red SDK on Windows and Linux. And all that means is that you also get decompression on the GPU, basically like getting a free update to your machine by simply just updating. Okay, so this is the machine I've been using since about beginning of 2018, and it's just to give you an idea of what it is that I'm running on now. Okay, so back in Resolve, I'll just go over the settings real quick just to make sure there's nothing funky going on. This is unchecked, so not using optimized media. There's no proxy mode on, render cache is set to none. So where you actually update this is in the system side of the preferences under decode options. And most of these should be on if you have an NVIDIA card. If you have an Apple card, then that's different. And this is the new feature they added. So for GPU, for r3d, you also have decompression now, where before we only had debayer. For the sake of argument and for the sake of demonstration, I'm just going to leave that on debayer. I'll just play back. I have it set to stop when it drops frames, and there it is, it stopped. Color grade is off. There's actually not anything on it, so it's dropping frames, stopped. And the reason for that is because under my project settings for red, I have it maxed out right now. So usually if I'm editing, I could leave it quarter res, 1/8, whatever. But as soon as you start getting into grading, it's a little bit more complicated because you don't really get to see the full quality of the thing that you're putting out. Okay, so over in the performance monitor, we can kind of see where it's sitting at baseline. Right now I'm running OBS Studio for the screen capture. Also doing a few other things sort of in the background on different desktops. So this is kind of where I'm at. And this is usually how I'll edit anyways. My computer never starts really fresh. I always kind of have something going on. But yeah, the GPU scopes and everything are on. And if I play back now, you can kind of see CPU maxes out. And you can kind of see that the GPU is being used, but it's not maxing out. Right now, CPU is still 100%. GPU is kind of where it's at. So I'm gonna go over and change that setting. Okay, so I went ahead and restarted, and this is where we're at. So we have decompression and debayer. And when we play back, we see that it is working amazingly well this time around. And even if I go ahead and disable the top track, it just hops into the bottom. So I could just be, you know, just disabling and enabling, kind of editing on the fly, and it just like automatically switching without any hassle. And the settings are still the same. So it's still a 4K timeline or an ultra HD timeline. Camera raw is still set to full everything. So now literally on my laptop on the go in a hotel, you know, in a cafe, or whatever it happens to be, I can just take, as long as I have a fast enough drive to keep up with all the footage I'm, you know, pumping out, it should be fine. And if I go into the color tab, you can see that the scopes and everything still keep up. You know, I can adjust my grades and it will do it. There's a little bit of lag at the beginning, but it does do them real time, even on this, you know, full resolution footage, which I forgot to mention before, but actually is coming from a Red Raven. The compression ratio was pretty high, so we're not even getting an advantage off being off a RAID necessarily. If you're shooting lower compression ratios, then having something like a higher end SSD is probably going to be more beneficial to you. In order to keep up these levels. If we switch over to the performance monitor again, while I keep this playing in the background, you notice that the GPU is almost used entirely now, where before the CPU was doing all the work. So it's literally flipped it around. So now CPU is sitting around 30%, which is, I believe, where the graphics card was sitting before. GPU now is almost maxed out, which means two things. It's gonna get very toasty. That's the first thing. And then the second thing is that you're going to have room to do a lot more creative decisions, even with full resolution footage, without having the drawbacks of needing necessarily a very fast server desktop or high-end desktop or whatever. So, I mean, if you're one of the people who are getting the new Mac Pro, or if you're getting a new PC, then this is one of those things that's just going to make it phenomenal for doing even like VFX compositing right inside of Resolve. Now, I haven't tested it, so I don't know how well it's actually going to work with Fusion. Fusion inside of Resolve has always been a little, we know. Okay, so that's going to be it for this video. It was just a quick thing to go over this one feature that I thought was absolutely mind-blowing. You know, it's something that people used to pay $10,000 for, not even just, you know, a few years ago, with the Red Rocket and Red Rocket X cards. And now that I can do it on my laptop, basically at a coffee shop. So this is one of those things that opens up a lot of doors for other creative ideas, because sometimes there was VFX things that I wanted to do that just weren't possible to do so. If you still want to do a proxy workflow for the sake of saving space and storage when you're sending files out, you can still do that. And even that's going to be faster just because of the, you know, the decompression is going to be on the GPU. So when you're transcoding, it should be quicker as well. I haven't tested that out, but it stands to reason that that would be the case. Okay, so thanks for staying till the end and watching all of that. Hopefully you found it useful. This is one of those features that, because of how they worded it, I feel could have flown under the radar. So I definitely wanted to highlight it. It's something I've been waiting for a long time, and I think it's definitely going to be a very big improvement, even if you're still doing proxy workflows. And if you want to see the full video that we're working with today, I put a link in the video description. So thanks again for stopping by, and I will check you guys out on the next video.